your life. And tonight, we're living it very dangerously for all sorts of unexpected reasons. We've had to switch the location of our very first surprise. You know, when I produced the book, about 20 minutes ago, I should have been over there at the Hilton Hotel, Park Lane, meeting that Rolls Royce you were watching. We have, in fact, been following it around all afternoon, and its glamorous guest on board, someone who was once known as Britain's number one sex symbol. We've been following her and it around. She's been filming for a television program, and right now she thinks, with the filming over, that she is being transported straight to another studio, when in fact, without her knowing, we have switched the plan. She's been switched to this studio, which, when she gets as far as this door to where I'm going now, becomes this theater. Now, I want you to watch for the Rolls Royce arriving outside our theater. You may not be able to see it very clearly because we dare not put on any extra lights because she might get suspicious. All right, well, that's it, I've been told. So let's keep fairly quiet, fingers crossed, because this lady very much has a mind of her own. And if anything goes wrong at this stage, we have no show.
Thank you.
Come in, Adam. Oh, no, you didn't expect to see me again.
Eamon! Oh, no!
Tonight, legendary glamour girl of the screen, Diana Dawes, this is your life. But things went wrong, so we met you here.
Oh,
Diana Dawes, this
place.
Is your life. A life that's had more cliffhanging moments than the plot of any movie. It began on October 23rd, 1931, when you were born at the Haven Nursing Home, Kent Road, Swindon in Wiltshire, near the family home at 210 Marlborough Road. Both your parents are, alas, no longer with us. Your dad, there he is, was an army captain in the Great War. But it was your late mother who encouraged your earliest show business aspirations. But you hadn't learned any of those later famous pin-up poses when this was taken, age just two. Went on to appear not only in dozens more films, but also become a star of television. And I know one of those television appearances was opposite this leading man 14 years ago. And he's been your leading man ever since, your husband, actor Alan Lake.
Oh!
And with him, your 12-year-old son, Jason.
Oh, oh my God. Obviously knew about all this.
Oh, God, did I know about it 3 weeks ago?
Oh, that's terrible. You see, it just goes through to be married to somebody and not know what's going on.
Alan, speaking of that, only the day after meeting Diana, you had a rather special gift for her, hadn't you?
That's right, yes, Eamon. It was an antique Mexican ring that a very good uncle of mine had given to me just before he died, on the understanding that I would promise to give it to the first girl that I saw that I was going to get married to.
But Diana, you'd only known each other a day or so. Were you surprised when Alan told you about his uncle and the ring?
I don't think I was thinking too much about his uncle at the time. I was too interested in him.
Well, less than 2 months after you'd met Diana, you'd another ring on your finger, this time a wedding ring, because you were married at London's Caxton Hall on November 23rd, 1968.
Diana Dawes, the perennial blonde bombshell, marries actor Alan Lake just 6 weeks after she first met him. It was sheer magnetism, said Alan, like the first taste of champagne. Diana was even more to the point. Meeting him was like being run over by an express train. Certainly looks as though he's got steam up.
Finds you a lifelong friend who, more than 20 years later, offers you a part in a film he's directing.
But I must warn you, Dawsey, the part doesn't exactly call for a sex symbol.
Writer, director, and currently starring in the comedy hit Tom, Dick, and Harriet, Lionel Jeffries.
Oh,
Lionel, this wasn't a glamorous role you wanted Diana to play.
Oh, I tell you how it started. I rang her up one night and I said, it's a part, I'm not too sure we're going to be happy about it, because I said, I'm going to destroy all that sex symbol rubbish. And she said, you always wanted to do that. And I said, yes, well, I'll tell you what it is. She said, what's the name of the picture? And I said, it's The Amazing Mr. Blunden. She said, I see, you want me to play Mr. Blunden? I said, no, it's Mrs. Wicking.
Oh.
So she said, well, go on. I said, well, we're going to pad you out to about 28 stone. She said, go on. I said, we're going to shove a wig on you, flea-bitten old grey wig. She said, go on. Anything else? I said, yes. To cap it all, we're going to stick a rubber wart on your nose with hair sticking out of it. She said, is that it? I said, that's it. She said, I'll do it.
And here you are, Diana, yes, a very different Anna Doris from the rank charm school days, as Mrs. Wickens in the film The Amazing Mr. Blunden.
Aren't you interested in cash, you great lump? Cash! £30,000 if he snuffs it.
And tell me, Lennon, what did she say, you know, when she saw herself in the mirror at the end of the makeup?
She said, well, you succeeded in destroying the myth, line. But you see, she received national and international acclaim for that performance, because you see, she proved once more, she's always doing, what a marvellous, exclusive actress she is. She's not just a good actress, she's a totally exclusive and extremely brilliant actress, and I love her very much.
Oh. Thank you, Lionel Jeffries. Comes the chance of a film in Hollywood. Your first marriage had been crumbling for some time, and your new involvement in America meant the final split. Dennis Hamilton died 2 years later, aged just 33. You returned to America for more film work and television specials with some of the biggest names in show business. And they don't come any bigger than the good friend who's in Los Angeles tonight, Bob Hope.
Hello, Eamon. Hello, Di. You know, when they told me Eamon was planning this surprise for Di tonight, I thought first they made a mistake asking me to appear. I just couldn't remember Lady Diana ever doing a song and dance number on my show in America. But then, well, they said it was Diana Doors. Let me tell you, going back a few years, he used to pop up, I said, on my show almost as regularly as Crosby. And when you first came over to the States, I immediately understood why our GIs over in Britain were in no hurry to return home after the war, especially from the place called, what was it, Swindon? Sure sounded like a hell of a town, a kind of English Las Vegas. Oh, don't know how I ever missed it when I was here. Anyway, when I first met you, I thought we might have a game of golf. You certainly had a natural swing. But when I asked you if you'd like to play a round, you said you didn't. But we became friends anyway. Seriously, my NBC show has been going 33 years this year, and recently we put together some clips of shows from the past under the title of Women I Love, and you were right there, because I love you a lot. And these days, there's quite a lot more of you to love. In fact, you're the only bit of the British film industry that's expanded. Just take care of her now, Eamon. Not too much excitement, because she's led a sheltered life, that girl. Have a great night.
Thank you, Bob Hope.
And, in fact, we thought we might get through the Guinness Book of Records. In fact, how many takes we'd get to get it right.
Because of the laughs, but you did eventually get it right, didn't you?
Just about, yes.
And we can take a peep at just what happened on the way to the washhouse.
Those curtains.
Mm, what about them?
They ain't to be washed.
Oh, you're a juicy young devil, ain't you? He's got a rolling eye.
Listen, ladies, all I want is...
We all know what you want, don't we?
Thank you, Richard O'Sullivan. Because of all the friends you've made in 35 years in show business, for you, one stands out from all the others for a very special reason.
I'm very flattered that you asked me to be the godfather of your child, Gary.
Not only that, but you and your son spent many happy hours at his home in California. Tonight he's due on stage in St. Louis, Missouri, but grabs the chance to talk to you now. International entertainer, Liberace.
Hello, Diana, and hello, Eamon. I am so happy to have this opportunity to talk to you. I have such fond memories of you, Diana, when you first came to California back in the days when we were both sex symbols. Remember? You came to my home in the valley in San Fernando, and we had such wonderful times together. Well, it's been many years since we first met, but I'm so proud of the fact that you've become such an accomplished actress. I'm still going strong, and I look forward to seeing you in in London when I come there next May. God bless you, Diana, and my best to all of your many admirers, and especially to you, Eamon. Thank you for inviting me.
Thank you, Liberace in St. Louis. And Diana, I close with a sentence you wrote yourself. As I gaze back in the looking glass of life, my three sons really are the fairest of them all. Jason here, of course, and your two sons who live in America, not in Hollywood tonight. For a happy ending, your son Gary and your eldest son, whom we haven't seen since you were in California 4 years ago. We've flown him here too, Mark. Diana Dawes, this is your life.
How close to me.